We're going to talk about Go, and we're going to talk about questions that you can use if you're an employer. You can use these questions when you have a coding interview, when you're interviewing Go programmers and you're looking for a Go programmer to hire. And if you are a Go programmer, you can use these questions, these videos, to prepare for Go programming interviews. There's a bunch of questions here. There's different code samples. There's different code problems to fix. And we're going to go through them one at a time. So this is going to be a whole playlist, a series of videos. You could find that link to the playlist in the description down below. And if you want to get to all of these questions, you could go to GitHub. And so come up to a browser, github.com. Go to Goes to 11. And then here inside, look, I was younger. Here inside Goes to 11. You know, every picture of you was taken when you were younger, even if it is only by nanoseconds. All right, and then in here you have this repo, Learn to Code Go version 3. So come into that, and this is the repo for my course on the Go programming language, which there's a link to it down here in the README. And so you could click on this, and it'll take you to Udemy. And at Udemy, Todd McLeod, there's the course. So if you want to learn more about Go or deepen or reinforce or just hang out with me or support me in making these videos, that's that course. And all the 000s are just my work folders. And then when we get down here, these are the folders for the course. So I kind of play with stuff up here. But here are the interview questions. So if you want to get to them, they're right there. Go enjoy it. Let's talk about the first question. And this first question can be deceptively, and we're going to categorize them as beginner, intermediate, or advanced. And this first question can be deceptively deceptive, right? You might think, well, this is just a beginner question. There's nothing I can do. And I call this a door closer question, because if you answer this question wrong, if you have kind interviewers, they will point that error out to you, and then you will exit the process, and you'll know where you made your mistake, and you could go advance your skills and then come back to an interview somewhere later. But this question is deceptive because you can answer it with just the simple answer. You could just define, like, you know, and describe what the difference is between making a slice of int and the values that you're passing in. And you could also use this question to display your knowledge, the depth of your knowledge, because this question here, and I'm going to put answers to questions right beneath the question, like that. And this question here allows you to get into all kinds of things. So for instance, you could go into value semantics, and you could also go into pointer semantics, right? So you could start talking about that. And you could start talking about mechanical sympathy, right? And if you start using these phrases, you're gonna see smiles start to rise on the people who are interviewing you that know something about Go. And you could talk about cache lines, right? And you could talk about the prefetcher and performance and optimizations, right? So you could talk about all that from this question. And you could also talk about, what else could you talk about? You could talk about append versus copy. And you could talk about, you know, the errors which can arise if you aren't paying attention when you're working with value semantics and pointer semantics. So there's a tremendous amount of things that you could think about and talk about here as you answer this question. I'm just looking here. I'm going to reflect for a moment and edit this out to see if there's something else I want to add to what you could talk about off of this question. Okay, another thing came to me because I was thinking about this in the night. You could also talk about the differences between declare, right, and assign, and initialize, and allocate. So you could talk about the differences to all those. I'm going to reflect for another moment, see if there's anything else I want to add in. Came up with one more thing that I could add in here, and I also made some notes here for declare, assign, initialize, and allocate. So if you want to pause and read through those are those notes right there. And the other thing that you could talk about in relation to performance is you could talk about the stack versus the heap, and you could talk about polluting the heap. And how slices allow us to really work in an efficient way with data structures, and how the slice is one of the most significant, if not the most significant, data structures in the Go language. You could talk about that also. You could also talk about the three different types of types, the three different categories of types, and those three different categories. So that would be when you're talking about value semantics and pointer semantics, those categories of types would be built-in types, like you have your bool, your numeric types, and your string. And then you also have your reference types, and then you also have your user defined types, or your structs, defined type and your structs. And so when you talk about those, you could also talk about the general rules of thumb for value semantics versus pointer semantics. And so basically you want to stick with value semantics. And if that is foreign to you, it's like, you know, how are you building your program? Are you using a lot of pointers? That's pointer semantics. Or are you using just the values? And you want to use value semantics by default. Keep things as simple as possible for as long as you can. And with built-in types and with reference types, the rule of thumb is definitely use value semantics. User-defined types like structs, you've got more flexibility there. But with these two, definitely as much as you can, try to use value semantics. So that's a rule of thumb that you could talk about. But in the different categories of types, built-in, reference, user-defined types. And so a slice is a reference type. And because of that, there are gotchas, which you have to be careful for when you're working with slices. Because you could talk about the data structure. There's one more thing that we could talk about here. So what is the data structure of a slice? And so a slice is a three-word data structure. And what does that look like? It looks like, you have a pointer to an underlying backing array, so a pointer, and then you also have the length, and you also have the cap. And so now we could talk about the mechanics up here. But like, these are all things, right? Like, you could look at this question, you could say, hey, this is an easy question, and you could explain the mechanics, but you can miss this opportunity. So this question's a door closer, because if you can't explain the mechanics, the door is closed. But it's also an opportunity for you to showcase your knowledge and value, and it's a doorway. Not only is it a door closer, it's a doorway into your new position. Because if you showcase everything you know, right, like this right here encapsulates all of this, and if you start saying, hey, let's talk about value and pointer semantics, let's talk about the different categories of type, built-in, reference, and user-defined type structs, let's talk about the general rules of thumb around value semantics and pointer semantics, let's talk about mechanical sympathy, cache lines, the prefetcher, and performance, let's talk about the stack versus the heap, and how working with slices allows us to avoid polluting the heap, and how that's like genius on the part of the creators of the language. Let's talk about how slice is one of the most significant data structures in the Go language. Let's talk about where did I say the three-word data structure? Let's talk about how slice is a three-word data structure. I'm going to move that up. That would be more up like there. Let's talk about append versus copy and how we need to use one or the other in different situations. And let's talk about declare, assign, initialize, and allocate. So those are all those things that you could talk about in relation to these. And if any of these don't make sense, take them to ChatGPT. Let me just show you this. And control C that. And you could come to ChatGPT. You could say, give me a new chat. And you could say, in the Go programming language, what is the difference between, and let's just see what I have, value semantics and pointer semantics, there we go. And so then we just run this, and it's going to give us an answer, and we could read through that. And Go semantics refers to how types behave during assignments and function calls. In particular, the semantics of a type is about whether its values are directly manipulated or whether they're indirectly manipulated. The distinction between value semantics and pointer semantics is crucial in Go, and understanding it can help you write more efficient and correct programs. And so I will copy all this, and I'm going to put this, so just so that we keep these things short, I'm going to put these longer notes down here. I'm going to Control X that, and then I have all of my longer notes all the way down here at the bottom. So you can just Control F through this document to search for whatever it is you want to find. But there is the longer note, and I will also copy this one for your ease of use. And I will put this one down here also. I'm going to put that in its own little thing because it's like, just group them. Or, yeah, that's what I'll do because maybe I'll change the numbering of the question. So there we go. So that's a little bit about that first question. It's a great question, and we need to talk about the mechanics, actually. So when you use make to make a slice, you're asked to give it a number or two numbers. You could give it just one number, in which case that number defines both the length and the cap. Or you could give it two numbers like this and specifically define the length and the cap. And if you give this a zero, then you're saying the length is zero. And length determines, how well you can work with the slice. if there are any values there that you can write to or read from. And so if the length is zero, there's no values there that you could write to or read from. And so when might you want to make length zero is when you're going to append values to a slice. You're going to make a slice and then append values to it, because it's going to start appending those values at position zero. But you'd want to specify a length and have a length in there already if you're going to start accessing some of those values by index position or writing directly to some of those values. So that's the difference between those two. You can learn more about that in my course. That's the first question. Hit like and subscribe so when the next video comes out, you could check out that next video. But also, you could go down to the description and click the link for the playlist, because maybe those videos are already there and you could watch the next videos in these questions. Preparing for a Go programming interview, whether you are the programmer and want to answer the questions well, or you're the employer and you want to ask questions well. See you next time.